The Leave Means Leave march kicked off last Saturday in Sunderland. I'm going to say the images have been less than inspiring.
That doesn't look like a march. That looks like a megabus has broken down.
And they're walking from Sunderland to London?
Yep.
And protest it because they want to leave. Why not walk from fucking Brussels to London if it's a bit easier? I think every single person on that march should have their laptop seized.
Question.
They should just pull a load of unsolved historic sex crimes and just randomly question these people. Just going, where the fuck were you on that night, mate? And just, you're going to get a couple of them, I reckon.
They're wearing these burqas, mate. This is our country. If they want to come into our country, they should at least be adapting to our culture. And I'm looking at this guy, thinking, I bet when he goes abroad, he really blends in. Walking about Lanzarote, looking for a Greggs.
Like Australia, 40 degrees. And this guy never understood what I was saying when I was asking for water.
Yeah.
So there's only so much you can play with on a word like water.
Yeah.
Try to make that T work. We like to get the T in a headlock. So I'm going water. And then what always happens is an English guy translates for us. They just appear. And that's pretty degrading when somebody is interpreting into the same language. That kind of speeds up your heart rate. Like, he's actually asking you for water. And then... then you need to watch the smug prick swagger away as if he's bilingual. So that's kind of what you go through.
David Cameron's never woke up at 3 o'clock in the afternoon. He's never had a packet of Flaming Hot Monster Munch for his breakfast. David Cameron's never known that feeling of waking up at 3 in the afternoon and your only goal for the day is to try and piss a skid mark off the inside of your toilet. I went into a clove shop in New York called Abercrombie and Fitch. You been there? Glasgow guy, you been there? No. I never knew it was that kind of shop. It's for the beautiful people, the staff. I don't mean that as a slant on you.
No, I never even went. They were having a vegan barbecue,
right,
which made me laugh. But then
yeah,
my neighbours said it was actually delicious, Kevin. The vegan, I was surprised as well. The vegan barbecue, because you can't beat a bit of toast.
Yeah.
Halloween's coming up. I think that's quite a hallucinogenic experience, Halloween, in this city. Any UK city, Halloween, because we don't really, in Scotland or England, we don't really have a laid-back festival, carnival culture. Now everybody gets dressed up, but there's still violence in the streets. I've walked in Sucky Hall Street on Halloween and I thought I was on something. I just everybody's dressed up, but emotions still run high. There's by no means in high spirits. There's Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles kicking fuck out of SpongeBob SquarePants. Dorothy for the Wizard of Oz, she's eating chips and cheese shouting, Barry, fucking leave him!
You speak Spanish. You learnt Spanish recently, didn't you?
Oui. Yes. That was a joke.
A double dip recession. I've got mates who've lost their job. I know people who have went beyond unemployed. I've got people in my social circle. I've got friends who I can only describe as being unemployed as fuck. I know that's not fully utilising the English language, but that's what's being created these days. People who have just been forgotten about, people who are unemployed as fuck. They've just been forced to embrace the rut they're in. They're sat at home, they've got their routines, home's under the hammer, then it's man versus food. They're fucking adamant they've been missold PPI. Every 15 minutes you see that advert on the phone, where's my fucking PPI then? I don't know what it stands for, but I would like it back. I need that money so I can adopt a snow leopard.
So you travel outside of the UK, your material travels well outside of the UK. Have you done Europe?
I've done Europe. We've done Australia and New Zealand just before this UK tour started.
Yeah.
It sounds a lot more glamorous than it actually is, because you're just performing to expats.
Yeah.
Like, okay, failed marriages and scousers on the run for crippling drug debts.
barbecue on Christmas Day, lads?
On the Snapchat, Instagram.
I remember watching a Danny Dyer documentary about the Old Firm. And it was good to see somebody like him. Danny Dyer, he's the prick's prick, isn't he? Good to see him. No, sometimes you just flick through the channels and you see he's on Britain's Most Deadliest Men, him talking to some big wall puncher. Guy's going, I'm the kind of bloke, if you don't mess with me, I'll be all right. But if you mess with me, I'll fuck you up. Danny Dyer's going, can I be your friend?
And then he was talking about how he was proud the American troops gave Bin Laden a respectful send-off at sea. And that kind of made me laugh, because I don't believe that the American troops gave Bin Laden a respectful. So I thought it'd be quite funny to walk on the stage and say, I bet the American Navy SEALs were riding Bin Laden's body on the back of that Navy ship like a banana boat, and I bet there was like Guns N' Roses music blaring. Bobby Joe, stick a flag in his. Because in my mind, that's what maybe happened. But I walked on stage to the audience, and then they never laughed. They just thought, what a diseased young man.